Welcome to all. I am Dr. M.R. Kadam, MSc in Analytical Chemistry and PhD in Material Science. Now we have seen the second step of the manufacture of the white sugar, that is clarification or depication of the juice. The juice collected from the mill house is greenish and opaque. This opaque appearance of the juice is due to the presence of some soluble impurities like glucose, fructose, salts, proteins, organic acids, phosphoric acid, gums, etc., and the insoluble impurities like finely divided peat and fiber along with mud. Before concentration, these impurities must be removed, otherwise they interfere filtration and purification of the sugar and decreases the yield of the sugar. The process of removal of these impurities from the juice is called as a clarification or depication. In clarification, juice is first screened through the perforated metal sheet. Remove the bigger floating impurities present on the surface of the juice. At this stage, this juice is acidic in nature, that is, its pH is 5 to 5.7. Due to this acidic nature, sucrose undergoes hydrolysis reactions and gives inverted non-crystallizable sugars like glucose and fructose. In the one-step process, the removal of this acidic nature of the juice and the clarification of the juice is carried out by using sulfitation process or double carbonation or the combination of carbonation and sulfitation. Now we have seen the most commonly used clarification process in one step process is the sulfitation process. In this sulfitation process, lime is added till the pH of the juice becomes 8, and then this limed juice is heated to the temperature 325 to 345 Kelvin. This increased alkalinity coagulate much of the colloidal impurities present in the juice more readily. Along with this, non-sugary impurities are also get precipitated. Now the sulfur dioxide gas is bubbled through this hot limed juice till the pH becomes 5.1 to 5.3. During this process, the precipitate of calcium sulfite, that is CaSO3, is formed, and this precipitate settles down at the bottom. During the settlement of this precipitate, it takes much of the colloidal impurities along with it. Then this juice is again relimed to the pH 7 and heated to boiling. At these conditions, almost all the impurities from the juice are removed. This sulfitation process is quick and gives better precipitation of the impurities. This process also causes the decolorization of the juice because this sulfur dioxide gas is bleaching agent. Now we have seen the second procedure used for the clarification of the juice in one step process is the carbonation process. In this carbonation process, carbon dioxide gas is passed through the hot limed juice, and in this pH is adjusted to get the good precipitation of the impurities and filtration. This method is cheaper than the sulfitation process and now becomes more and more popular. This achieves good results, but it has to be repeated. That means it is double carbonation process must be used. So in this carbonation process, first juice is heated at about 328 Kelvin, and then lime is added till the pH becomes 10.8 to 11, and this condition is kept for 5 minutes. Due to this, very excessive pH precipitates gums, pectins, etc. much more completely. After that, the CO2 is passed through this hot limed juice till the pH becomes 7.5. When we pass the carbon dioxide gas through the hot limed juice, the surplus lime is removed as a precipitate of calcium carbonate. So this precipitate of the calcium carbonate during the settlement takes away several impurities along with it, and for double carbonation process, this whole procedure is repeated again. After that, juice is filtered through the specially designed filters. After filtration, we get the filtrate, which is colorless, clear liquid, and it is then sent to the multiple effect evaporator for the concentration.